फ्रेंड्स, लेट अस नाउ अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट द कंसेप्ट ऑफ फ्री फॉल. सी, फ्री फॉल, ओके, अ फ्रीली फॉलिंग ऑब्जेक्ट टूवर्ड्स द अर्थ विल बी कॉल्ड एज अंडर द ऑब्जेक्ट इज फॉलिंग अंडर फ्री फॉल. अंडरस्टूड? एनी ऑब्जेक्ट रिलीज्ड फ्रॉम हाइट, इट विल बी पुल्ड टूवर्ड्स द अर्थ एंड द फॉल ऑफ दैट ऑब्जेक्ट कैन बी कंसिडर्ड एज फ्री फॉल. बट वेट, how we define free fall? Free fall is a fall in which the object should be under the influence of gravitational force. Now you'll ask me, okay, there is gravitational force, the object is being pulled towards the earth. Wait, there are two more factors, okay? Actually, when a object is falling in air, there is frictional force between air and the object, which is in opposite direction to the gravitational force. And also there is one more force called as buoyant force. Both are against the direction of gravitational force. So literally, when an object is falling in air, we can't call it as free fall. But if the same object is falling in vacuum, under conditions of what? Vacuum, where there is no air, towards the earth, okay, towards the earth, but it's not possible because earth is surrounded by atmosphere and earth is having air around it. So definitely the object will fall in air. But suppose if on another planet an object is falling towards the planet and there is no air, nothing but vacuum, then that fall of the object can be considered as free fall. Okay, now any object released from a height, okay, suppose I take an object from a height of 100 meters, I release the object. And you ask me how much time it will take to reach the earth. Okay, how can I calculate? I can easily calculate this by using the three equations of motion which you have learnt in 9th standard. Those three equations of motion were, first was giving relation between velocity and time, v equal to u plus at. Second was the relation between displacement and time, s equal to ut plus half at square. And third used to give the relation between velocity and displacement, and it was v square equal to u square plus 2as. V equal to u plus at, second s equal to ut plus half at square, and third v square equal to u square plus 2as. These three equations of motion will be helpful for us for finding the time required for the object to move from that height to the ground. One thing you understand, as the object is coming down, its velocity will increase, and that's why acceleration due to gravity will be positive. G will be what? Positive. Getting it? And secondly, when the object is released from the height, its initial velocity will be always taken as zero. Initial velocity means u is equal to zero. Getting it? And that's why the three equations of motion will slightly change. What will be these three equations of motion and how will we write it? Let's see on the board. An object freely falling towards the earth, okay? And these are the three equations of motion which we have learnt. Now in this case, value of A will be taken as equal to small g. Positive, okay, plus g. Value of u will be taken equal to zero because initial velocity is zero. Then this first equation will change as v equal to g t. The second equation will become, okay, s equal to half g t square because this term is zero and a will change to. And third, v square will be equal to 2gs. Okay, over here value of s will be taken as the height. Okay, value of s will be nothing but the height of the object. So we get these three equations which will be used when an object is released from a height. Value of a will be plus g.